kind of toying around with some new video ideas, which is why I haven't uploaded anything in a while. That, and you know, life gets in the way. I've got two nephews and a niece that I love spending time with, family that I love spending time with, friends that I'm reconnecting with, you know, all that kind of stuff. So just creating content hasn't been at the top of my priority list lately, but that's about to change. I have some new ideas that will be coming at you soon. But today's video is going to be a book chat, and I'm kind of going to just talk about some of the stuff that I've read recently and some of the stuff that I'm reading now. So, without further ado, let's get into some of the stuff I'm reading now, and then we'll roll into some of the stuff that I have read already. So the book that I'm currently working on right now is Assassin of Truths by Brenda Drake. This is a Library Jumpers novel. So far, so good. I will say that this was one that I had to really, it took me a minute to get back into it. It's been a while for me since I've read the second one. I read it shortly after it came out, which I believe was in 2016, towards the end of the year. So it did take me a hot minute to get back into this book. I had to really, like, try and go back and remember, you know, who they were talking about. I did remember the three, a few of the main characters. So I did remember Bastion. I did remember Gia is the main character. I remembered Eric, and then I also remembered her grandmother, who now I can't remember what they call her, but her name's Katie, which makes me giggle a little bit because, hey, that's my name. Anyway. So, like I said, it did take me a minute to get back into this book, to get back into, like, the world, because it kind of just jumps right in. Not that that's a bad thing. A lot of times with books, I really like it that it just picks up right where the last one left off, because there was, for example, I just finished Restore Me, which is the new Shatter Me book number 4. From Taheta Mafi, and I absolutely loved that book. I wrote a review for it, so I'll leave the link to my blog down in the description box below if you guys are interested in reading it. But I just finished that one like the end of last week, and it was amazing, and I was so happy with it. But I had just reread the beginning of the trilogy because I got them for Christmas, so I kind of quickly reread them in anticipation for this book, and that one pretty much started right where the third one left off. Another example would be I read Tarnished City by Vic James, which is book number 2. The first book was Gilded Cage by Vic James, and Tarnished City literally started right where Gilded Cage left off as well. So it's not always a bad thing when a book jumps right in, right at the end of the previous book. However, like I said, this one, it had just been a while since I read the second book. There was a little bit more of a gap in between. Not that there wasn't a gap between, you know, book 3 and 4 in the Shatter Me series, because what was it, 4 years between book 3 and book 4? So, but Taheta Mafi had announced last year that she was going to be writing more, so I was really excited about that. But anyway, so Assassin of Truths is what I'm currently working on, and so far so good. I'm really enjoying it, and I'm hoping that the pace pretty much stays fast, because it has moved rather quickly, I feel. And I do enjoy that in a book. So my next choice, don't make fun of me. I've been in a spring cleaning kick, like, big time. For example, this table that I'm currently sitting at was piled high with crap, which was another reason I wasn't filming videos, because I lost my filming space. My table was full of stuff. So I'm kind of in a spring cleaning kick, and I am going to blame that on Melissa Maker and her Clean My Space YouTube channel. And I just happened to be looking at like spring cleaning stuff at the library, and this book popped up, and I was like, oh, I follow her on YouTube. I might as well pick up the book. And it's really great. I have actually used pretty much all of the ideas that she gives you, all of the little tips and tricks that she gives for cleaning. Some of them I had already been doing without realizing. So one of the tricks that she says is to work in front, find it like a focal point in the room and work in a circular, work like clockwise. So I actually already do that. So my sink in my kitchen is my focal point, and then I will like go around and wipe stuff down that way. Like it's just, that's just an example. Or like use your front door as the focal point. So I use my front door as the focal point and I work like from the wall and around in a circle. It helps make things more efficient, and that's really what this book is about. It's keeping your cleaning efficient, making it so that way it doesn't take you hours to clean, which I know most of us don't have hours to clean. So for me, I have a couple of days off during the week, so which is nice because then I'm able to, you know, get my cleaning done, but I still don't want to spend the entire day on it, so... I'm really enjoying this book. I'm not all the way through it yet. I think, let's see, where am I? I want to say I'm on chapter 7. I'm on the bathroom. But the other cool thing about this is it does break your cleaning habits down into rooms. And then from there, it also breaks it down even further. So you get two different, like, cleaning routines, I guess you could call them. One would be, like, the 15-minute quick clean, kind of like the surface clean, just to make it look nice for if you have company coming over or something. And then the other one is the really deep clean. So that's the other reason I like this book, is she breaks everything down by room. She breaks everything down even further, so you have two different routines you can follow. She also gives you really great tips on what type of tools you should have, because if you don't have the right tools to clean, you're not gonna, you know, keep your space as clean as you would want it. She also has recipes in there for homemade solutions, which I really like because I make most of my solutions. There is going to be a video coming up in a couple of weeks that will have some things that I haven't made in them because I just ordered some stuff. But I'll explain more of that in a couple of weeks when I do that video. I've really been enjoying this book. I do have a couple of others in my pile, but this one is the one that I haven't read already, and it's really, really great. So I definitely recommend that one. And then another, I've been in like a contemporary romance kick lately. So Abby Glines is one that I've been reading a lot of lately. I finished her Seabreeze series. This is book number 4. Simple Perfection in her Rosemary Beach series, I believe. I've got to check. Sure. But I read, so the Rosemary Beach series is like broken up into different series, kind of. So like I read the Too Far series, and I have the Perfection series, and then, which is this one. And then I have another one of them. I have 4 books by her total in my little reading nook right now. So, but her books are really good. They're fast reads. They're not really anything that's too hard and dense to get into. I like to read them between my, like, the novels that I review and stuff. Because, like I said, I did a review on Restore Me, and in between... And I did a review on Tarnished City. So between those two books, I read a couple of her books. And I didn't do that with Assassin of Truth, only because I've been waiting for this book for like a month, and I was really happy when I got in. So I just started it right away. But I'll probably take a break from like the heavy reading for a while and read a couple of her books. So that's what I've been reading lately. That's kind of what I've got on my currently reading pile. I'm not going to do anything of what I'm going to be reading because I'm waiting on a few things right now, and I have a lot of things that are in my basket, and I'm not really sure what I want to read yet next. So I am going to talk a little bit about some of the stuff that I have read. My handy dandy phone, and I'm going to pull up my Goodreads. By the way, you guys can find me on Goodreads. I'm just Catherine. My picture on my Goodreads account is the same one that's on my YouTube. And I currently have 980 books shelved total. That's between my have read, my currently reading, and my to read. Okay, so I read The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas, and I do have to say that I was highly disappointed by this book. And I don't know if it was because it was such a highly rated book and hyped up and whatever, but I really did not like it. I do have a review on my blog on it, so if you guys are interested in knowing more, check out the review on there. Like I said, I'll leave my blog link below. The next book I read was Still Me, book number 3 in the Me Before You series by JoJo Moyes. I really did enjoy that book. I felt that this time she really wrapped things up, so that was great. Again, I do have that one on my blog as well. I read book number 3 in the Wicked trilogy by Jennifer L. Armentrout. Okay, so after reading that book, I will admit that I kind of went on a JLA kick for a long time. A long time. So I read Brave, which I thought was really good. I did a review of all 3 books together. That's on my blog. And then I also read 2 other series by her. The one was the Covenant series. Book number 1 was Half-Blood. 2 was Pure. 3 was Deity. 4 was Apollyon. And 5 was Sentinel. I read all 5 of those books, and I also read the prequel little novella that she wrote goes before Half-Blood called Demon. And I thought those were really good. Now, I didn't read those first originally. I actually read the Titan series first, which is The Return, The Power, and The Struggle. And then she has book number 4 coming out. This is coming out tomorrow. So this is the 19th. Tomorrow's the 20th. So it's coming out tomorrow. And, so she's got book number 4 coming out tomorrow, and I'm really looking forward to that. So, I read the Titan series first, and then I found out that there was another series before it, the Covenant series. So I went back and I read the Covenant series, and then I read the Titan series again because I felt like I missed things. So, I'm just going to end up buying the books. I reorganized my bookshelves because I want to purchase these books. But anyway, basically anything JLA I've been reading lately. I also read her Moonlight Sins, which is her new series, the DaVincent Brothers or whatever, which was really good. And then I read her series that she wrote as Jaylen. I forget what the series is called, though. Let's see. The Wait For You series. And I've also read the Beautifully Broken series by Courtney Cole, which is really good. So after my JLA kick, though, I read the book Wild Beauty by Anna Marie McLemore. And that one was really good. I did really enjoy that one. I felt like it was magical realism for sure. It kind of reminded me a little bit of Like Water for Chocolate in the way that they use the magical realism. So I highly recommend that one. I thought that was really good. I don't think I did a review of that one. Now I have to look. But it was a really good book. The next one that I read was Glitter by April Lynn Park. April Lynn Pike. This video is like crazy. Sorry, guys. April Lynn Pike, I read both Glitter and Shatter. I really, really enjoyed both books, and I highly, highly recommend them. If you guys liked the Chemical Garden series, you will like this one, because I feel like the writing is similar to the Chemical Garden series, some of the circumstances are different and everything, but I feel, I don't know, I just, when somebody asked me to compare it to a series, that would be what I had to do. This is a duology, though, so there are only two books, Glitter and Shatter. I do have those up on my blog and reviews, so I highly recommend those. What else? What else? I think besides that, besides the books that I just listed, like I said, I read the Seabreeze series by Abby Glines, and I'm currently working on the Rosemary Beach series, and I read the Frigid duology by Jennifer L. Armentrout, Frigid and Scorched, and then Restore Me, which is book number 4 in Shatter Me, and now I'm currently working on Assassin of Truths. So that's like the quickest way I can think to give you guys an overview, because I have read a lot. So a lot. So if you guys are interested in knowing anything else about what I've been reading, leave me questions in the comments down below. I'd love to know what you're working on. Also, so I set a reading challenge this year on Goodreads, and I have read 100, I want to read 110 books, and I am currently at 46 of 110. That's how much I've been reading. 46 books in 3 months. That's craziness. Anyway, let me know if you guys set a Goodreads goal. Let me know what it is down in the comments below. And tell me where you're at in it, too. If you guys are currently working on it, if you've started it, let me know where you're at. I'd love to know.